realize one day at a time. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. They're here to get your day going fine. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio.
And here's your host, Miss Kim Robinson.
You abandoned Amen, amen. Welcome to Real Issue with Pastor Bello. And this is Kimmy Kim. Sister Vigo is doing her finishing up for the book. And Christina is working on the project. And Miss B is probably sleeping. But we got our special guest, Howard Sapp, coming on and talk about his life journey as a wonderful gospel artist. So I'm going to pass the mic to Pastor Bello. Are you there, my sister, my beautiful sister?
I am here, and we have two special guests. We have veterans, and we also have Howard Sapp. And the reason we have them on the show is to promote their international concert that they're doing starting this weekend.
Amen. I wish I had some songs. I would love to play
them. Well,
don't
worry. Here's your chance to do some more because this is just the beginning of them going internationally. We are trying to work things for the UK and also Nigeria.
Amen. Oh. Amen.
Yes. And as you notice that we're doing it a little bit different because we're trying to try out the actual network, and I'm trying to see how it's going to do with us being away because I want some of the footage to be played live while we're over there. So before we begin, I'm going into prayer. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for the abundance that you have given us. Lord God, you have been so good to us, and we thank you, Lord. Lord God, we are here tonight because we need to hear a word from you. Lord God, we know that you are so very good to us. And Lord God, we want to just ask you to continue to dwell with us. Lord God, search us. If it's anything not of you, remove it now by the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, as we sleep and slumber, we ask you to surround and protect us. Do not let any hurt, harm, or danger come before us. Lord God, we send in a special prayer for our guest artists because they're going out to evangelize for you. Lord God, show up and show off in their lives while they're doing the concert. Lord God, we ask you to make them your tangible, walking, talking testimonies. Lord God, dwell with us. In your name we pray, amen. Amen. So what we're going to do, they don't really
amen.
Have that long, but
okay.
They did dedicate a little bit of time for us because, you know, they're planning their actual trip. Some of us are leaving very early. And
wow, I'm jealous. I want to go to Jamaica. I want to go.
It's not a long flight, but, you know, for artists, they got a lot of preparations to do because both of them I have seen perform, and they do nothing less than 110%. And I am really just there to facilitate, and they're just bringing and showering down on us what God has already given to them. So I just want to make sure they're on the line. Do we have Howard Sapp?
Good evening, Pastor. I'm here. How you guys are doing? Glad to be here tonight.
Amen. We are blessed and highly favored. Do we have the Corinne?
In the building. Thank you guys for having me. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with some questions, and y'all can give me the answers. And basically, we just want to know about you. And also, Sister Kimmy, they will be having live interviews around 10 o'clock Jamaica time, which is 1 hour behind Eastern Standard Time. So that means
okay.
It'll be 2 hours behind you. So
okay.
That'll be going on live. I'm going to be doing it live, and also it'll be live on the Jamaican radio station. So that's happening on Saturday.
I'm so jealous.
Right now,
I'm going to the beach. I'm so jealous. I know it's going to be fun.
What I want to know from first, Howard, is really when did you start your music?
Oh man, starting my music. I've been singing ever since I can remember. I know, you know, starting out at a young age, coming from a singing family, basically, My brother and sister and myself, we had a little trio we called the Sapp Trio. I was probably about 5 years old, if that, and we used to go around. My father, he sang, and he was in ministry, and he sang, and so he put us together, and we began to sing in church and in other areas in the community, you know, at community events and that type thing, and just going around singing. Yeah, so we were called the Sapp Trio. So I've been singing, like I said, ever since I can remember. That's always been a part of me and who I am and growing up. And then from there, you know, continued to sing in church and in school and that type. And I actually went to college singing. So I've been singing ever since I can remember. But then getting into ministry and really allowing, you know, God to utilize that, you know, for His glory. I remember at one time when I was in working in Memphis, Tennessee, I was actually you know, preparing to sing with this band, which was a secular band, and they were, you know, very, very good, and they asked me to sing, and we were getting ready to do some concerts for a couple of radio stations and really take off in that. But God had, you know, said no, that wasn't the way that He wanted me to go. So He you know, touched me, and I just had to tell them, you know, I appreciate everything, but you know, I had to follow the call of God, you know, and that's, you know, I began to sing and stay with gospel, and God has been with me ever since.
Amen, amen. And what I'm going to ask the Corinth, because if you haven't heard him, he has his own unique style, and that's what attracts everybody to him. So what I want to know is, was that developed, or did you, you know, do trial and error to figure out, you know, because I know a lot of different artists, they try out one way, and then they wind up, you know, having the spirit to lead them in a totally new direction as far as the rhythm of the music. So how did it go for you, the Krim? Is anyone there?
I'm here. I'm here. I'm sorry. I'm here.
Okay.
I'm here. I was talking and everything. No, but the way that it happened for me was a lot of things, you know, I didn't just sit down and say, oh, hey, I'm going to rap about this or I'm going to rap about that. It was basically very personal experiences. You know, when we were little, I was raised off welfare and things like that. So, you know, being raised off welfare and having a single parent and then sharing a bed with your brothers and sisters, you start to understand things as they're being taught to you. So seeing that side of life and then seeing my mother be abused by certain men and so on and so forth, you know, and then music has always been in my family. And I always was the oddball out of all my my cousins, my siblings and things like that. So it was like over the years, I used to always pray to God to give me a voice, you know, to say things a certain way. And I was always told that I couldn't communicate and things like that. So I took those things in as I seen what my mom went through. And as I started to experience those things, it was like a generational curse. And I experienced those things. It was like, you know, I used to sit down and I would write things on paper all the time. And before you know it, I would have a notebook full of things that I wrote about personally, because I was talking to like I was talking to God. And when I got saved is when it really, you know, took root. And one of the CMG employees really was the person that showed it to me and said, you write your music in parables, just like Jesus, you know, wrote in the Bible. And when I looked at that and I saw that, started really like, okay, God, are you really doing me like this? Because Jesus always gets me in a position to take something very personal and tell the world about it, you know. And I have no problem with sharing what I went through with the world, but I use it. I was always told that you take yourself and put yourself in the scriptures of the Bible, so that way you can see how God has a plan for you. And that's what I do with everything that I write. I don't try to, you know, water it down, sugarcoat it, or anything like. I have to hit it dead on, because I want somebody to understand and gravitate to gospel hip hop, because a lot of people don't use it effectively, and some do, some don't. But you know, God, I would say God developed my style. It wasn't something that I picked up. It developed through Him.
Amen. Also, I'd like to add out there is that we do have some pictures that's showing actually on Facebook while we're live. And just share it because we want to get the word out there. If you know someone in Jamaica, let them know. We're going to be at the Pentecostal Church, which is in Runaway Bay. If you need more information about it, please, it's Pastor Rhonda, one word, Bello, I am me, and I will give you the information because we want to make sure. You never know, and I tell people this all the time, you never know where you're going to get your blessing, and you don't want to miss it. So, therefore, I'm always telling people to go out on our page to the event. Elations have theirs with events and see what's going on. You want to make sure that we support and lift each other up. Now, the next question I have, I feel like, you know how you be on a guest show and you be like, okay, I want theology for 500.
Pass the bell.
But the next one I have for Howard is, now, I've already heard, you know, you have, I'm going to tell you, you have different styles because you can do fast, you can do slow. But the question I have for you, are we going to get like a song or any type of preview, or you're going to keep everything, in, you know, to yourself? You ain't going to share it with us.
No, it's as far as me and coming, you know, I'm just how the way that God put the songs and everything together, and I was just actually listening to the set with my daughter today as we were driving. We were actually going to Bible study, and we were listening to the set, and I was just amazed at how God just put things together. You know, you do have a little bit of fast, you do have a little bit of slow, but everything is in just like you know, the CD that I have out, Look at God. Everything was pointing towards God, and all of the songs that He selected. You know, because I mean, I can I've gone through and I, you know, had a list of songs that I said, well, this is good, this is good. We can do this, and just going through, and then how God began to weed things out, and how God began to add songs and take songs away and stuff, and then the final product came, and it's like, wow, God, you know, just and how things just began to flow, and everything. Every song has a place, you know, the fast songs has a place, the slow songs has a place, and it's just the way that God had actually orchestrated it, and it just amazed me of how He put things together, and you know, I'm just excited, I really am, to see, because, you know, as I go, and I, you know, for me, you know, it has to minister to me first, and that's the way that I look at it, and that's the way that I receive it, that it first ministers to me, because I feel that, you know, if it's not talking, you know, to me, and if it's not touching me, then how can I express that so that it would actually touch and talk to someone else? You know, so it has to, if it's not moving me, how can I in such a way, you know, relay that to you so that it's going to move you? And that's the way that God does when it comes to me. And then a couple of the songs, the song that He's given me to write, you know, those songs move me first. And that's how, you know, I minister and how I just allow God to just use me. Because I just say it's not me. It has nothing to do with me. You know, so He's ministering to me, and then through me, He's ministering to others. And I just say, Lord, You just have Your way. You know, so the songs that He's just put together, you know, it's just, you know, talking about, you know, how much we love God, how blessed we are, you know, just how we praise and how we worship Him, and just, you know, just giving him thanks and all things. And it's just, you know, how those songs and how that said just ministered to me. And I'm just like, God, you are just awesome. You know, so I'm just looking forward, you know, to come and just allow God to show up and show out in a mighty, mighty way. We're just a vessel. That's all it is. You know, God, I'm just there. Lord, just open me up and just do whatever You want to do. You know, I'm wherever You say go, I'll go, you know, but if it's me, take me out of the way, because I can do nothing. I can do nothing but just let Him do everything that He wants to do. Like you said, you don't know where your blessing is going to come from, you know, so just as much of I pray that we are a blessing to those that would come and be a part. Truly, truly, it's going to be a blessing for us also. So you're going to get, you know, what God has for you, but you're going to get a little bit fast. You're going to get a little bit of slow. But as long as you get the word of God through music, you're going to get exactly what you need.
Amen. So I guess I need to tell everyone to bring the comfortable shoes and not the cutie patootie.
Don't be cute about it. Don't be cute about it, because we're not coming in to be cute, and we're not coming in any form or fashion. However God does it, we're coming to have a good time.
Amen. Amen. I'd also like to do a one shout out to Sister LaShawn. She does our media, and she has her own show on Mondays, which is Media Ministry. And she also has a Thursday show. But I like her. She's actually putting up the footage for us, because I had a lot that I'm trying to still do for our show. So I know when I talk to give the Corinth this question, because he do have some new music, and I'm not for sure exactly when he's going to start actually doing a tour on it. But it's the floor is yours. Let us know.
Well, tonight, you know, I actually left the studio about a half hour ago, and I'm gonna do some of the music when we get out there in Jamaica. You know, I'm anxious to do some of this new music because I went through a lot to get to this point. So, you know, like Howard said, you know what I'm saying, don't be cute about the shoes that you want to wear to this performance, because I'm coming to minister, but I'm coming to have fun with everything that God has laid on my heart to do, and I'm excited about the new album. My new single, King, is coming out in probably like a month or so, you know, once, you know, I sit down with Howard Sapp and decide on how we're going to do it. But, you know, this new album for me is very personal. It's going to outdo my first album, to be honest with you, because there's a lot of songs on there for women. There's a song on there for my mom I dedicated to her called Dear Mary. There's a song on there, you know, for, you know, dedicated Howard Sapp, you know, him, the people on CMG, the women in this world, you know, there's a lot of things that I'm saying. There's a lot of things God helped me with, but most importantly, God sat me down and helped me to be able to listen to the music so that way I can direct my words the way he wanted me to, so that way I can not only just, you know, speak a certain way and deliver and praise and worship and so on and so forth, but he wanted me to pretty much, you know, show people, you know, that, you know, in the kingdom, in the kingdom today, we are undisputed. You know, the devil try to fight us every day, but no matter what comes through us, every door that opens, we always win. We always win with Jesus Christ. So the new music is undisputed music. It's fight music. It's music to make you think. It's music that you can grow on. And, you know, I'm going to be doing a few songs while I'm out there this weekend. So, you know, I'm definitely bringing some good music to the table.
Amen. Amen. So I want everyone that is on Facebook, if you do have a question, just to type it in, because we're monitoring the actual live feed, and we'll make sure that question get out. Now, if you have a question afterwards, even if you still type it after we finish, it still will roll over to the Blessed Network. I will ask it during the carpet, which we're having out there. I will ask our two artists those questions, because, like I said, we want to make sure we get to actually know them, and we want to spread the word that God is doing a new thing in our lives, and that is presenting these two artists to us. So, Sister Kimmy, do you have any questions for our artists?
Absolutely. I have a quick question. What made you realize that singing is your purpose?
Which artist?
Oh, both. I'm so sorry. First, I'm going to start with Brother Sapp, and then I'll go to the next brother. How did you know that singing was your passion? Did you get that through experiences, or was it brought to your attention, you know, just because, you know, God put that on your heart? You know how some people learn their purpose based on their experiences, or God may just give that vision to you. How did you know that this was like a purpose?
For me, with singing, like I said, I've been singing pretty much all my life, and I knew that you know, in singing, you know, that even in singing, it actually brought me joy. But I also knew, even as and as I continued to grow in music and in singing and that type, how music and not just singing, but music, you know, how important that is. Actually, in everybody's life today, music is such an important and integral part, you know, even for people that say that they can't sing or whatever, but music plays such an important part because it can touch you and it can bring you to a place of emotion, you know, psychologically, you know, that people that just talking, you know, cannot do. And, you know, how God has just blessed me with singing and just being able to express myself through song, you know, that you know, I realized that in, you know, as I was growing up, like I said, in young age, whatever, I just got up and sang because, you know, my father said, you know, you guys are singing over here, so we just got up and we began to sing, so that was no problem. But as I grew and in the talent and the gift that God had given, I began to see how that actually touched me, but then it also touched other people, you know. So and with that, you know, I continue to sing and I continue to grow more and more in that gifting and that talent and how I saw how it touched me. And then I began to see how the music began to touch others, you know, and I'm like, wow, you know, this is something that is amazing. And it's such that question. I can go in so many different directions because I can go in ministry with that. I can go in just personal. I mean, that question, like I said, I can, you know, go in so many different directions with that. But just seeing how music actually touches people, but the gift that God had given me to actually communicate, you know, His word through song that would actually draw people to Him, you know, I began to see and realize that and how, you know, God just began to just move in that area. And regardless of what I did, I don't care what where I was or whatever point in my life, I could always go back and begin to sing an old hymn or sing something that, you know, that I can just lose myself in, because I can tell anybody. When I'm in church or whatever, I can begin to just praise and worship, and we can just have church with praise and worship, and we don't even have to do anything else. I can just stay there all day long. So,
I want to go. I'm jealous. I want to go to Jamaica.
Different places. It's going to be opportunities for you, Sister Kim.
Okay. You guys will have some fun.
Amen. So I'll just let it close with that. I'll let the crimp talk a little bit.
Okay. Well, you know, it's kind of different for me, you know, because being a hip hop artist, you got to really know, you know, the direction you're going when you write a song. And everything that I write about has some of a personal view to it, you know. And when I realized that it was my passion was, you know, when I started to understand what Scripture says, you know, when the devil tries to really fight you on what you want to do and what you're trying to do, and he tried to put up a roadblock and try to send his minions and, you know, try to send things to stop you at all times, that right there is a clear sign to me that when you're doing something right and the devil gets in your business, you must be a threat to his kingdom. You must be. So for me to understand the power of words also, that helped me to understand I can rip a person apart with rap music. But why would I want to do that? And I'm held accountable for everything that I do. You know, and then also the third thing is when I saw, you know, what my mother went through, when I saw that side of life, I just knew that if God kept me in music and he got me to this and he got me this far and he blessed me with a ministry and a team of people to go out here and share the gospel, you know, and everything that I've done and how the attacks keep coming and coming and coming and how God is still showing me like, yeah, you're going to win regardless. You know, I make it my personal job to do everything right. That's why I learned every job in this business. I wanted to learn it. I wanted to make for sure that I was equipped enough to where I sat down at any table, went in any room, walked across any stage, that I deliver everything. I pour everything that's in me and I leave it all on the stage, leave it all on the table, board table, whatever, or what have you. You know what I mean? But I take gospel music, I take gospel hip-hop music, I take it very, very serious. And I take it serious because somebody's listening. My mother told me one time, she said, make sure you write the truth. Write what you feel. If you're saying something to somebody, make sure you say exactly what you want to say to them, because music will last forever. It's always something in a song that somebody's looking for. So for me to be a gospel hip-hop artist, I want to bring everything to the table, everything that I got to say about what I went through, a personal experience, ministry, preaching, whatever I got to do, because you never know who's listening. You never know who's out there to receive it. A lady came up to me one time. I did a show, and this one really hit home for me. I did a show in Iowa. And when I did the show, I was breaking down my set, and I was getting ready to walk off stage. And as I was getting ready to walk off stage, it was this lady standing there with these glasses on, and she was standing there with a little girl. And when I was walking off stage, she called me. She said, sir, she said, can I talk to you? And, you know, I said, yes, ma'am. She said, you know, this is my daughter. Her daughter's name was Rylan. And I remember it like it was yesterday. She said, we don't have much money. We came to the festival to hear the music. She said, but I love your music. I would listen to you. She said, I don't listen to gospel hip-hop music, but you, I will listen to. She said, my daughter, you know, wants good new music. Is it possible she can follow you on Facebook to listen to your music? And that right there touched my heart to see a 12-year-old little girl, and her mother was blind, you know, and they sat there and they waited because something they got from the songs that I did touched their heart, and it was gospel hip-hop music. And I gave them my music for free because the gospel is for free. But it's the fact of the matter that, you know, that showed me that somebody's listening. So no matter what stage I walk across, my passion for this is to make sure that I can touch each and every heart, or touch the right hearts, or touch the hearts that God puts in front of me at the appointed time.
Amen. That's a good story right there, because it does touch you when someone tells you that they're listening to you, because then you know that the direction that God is leading you is actually sowing seed in a person's life. And that's a very good story. Because, see, the thing about it is that they look at you as artists, but they see you as when you wake up, the sun is always shining. When you leave out, you have no problems, no complications. They don't know. You can put through the fire sometimes harder than an average person, because the devil is not happy with what you're doing. So that's why you get put through extra dose of heat some days. I mean, some days you have to probably even, you know, minister through song to yourself just to, you know, to get up. So you're right that, you know, this one story can have you, you know, just knowing that God is God and he is moving through people's lives. So that's a very, very good story. Did you have another question?
Of course, they are powerful. I'm enjoying myself with these wonderful brothers in the Lord. So, with that being said, how do you write your songs? Do you have a special place where you go to write your songs, or do you have, you know, a room, or do you write them based on have experience at that particular moment? How do you write your lyrics? Where do you get them from?
So much like what Corinne said, you do get your lyrics a lot of times from life's experiences, you know, and then you go from there, you know, and I talk to a lot of, you know, artists and, you know, songwriters, or, you know, artists that want to write songs, and kind of give them, you know, so how to put a song together and that type of thing. But, you know, the first thing, even as, you know, as a gospel artist, contemporary, whatever, you want to, you know, get a story and have a story to tell. But then, you know, how you put that story together. And that's the way that, you know, what kind of message am I looking for? You know, who's my target audience? Who am I trying to reach? You know, and what message do I want to give them? Is it a message of hope, a message of salvation, a message of healing, or just a message of encouragement, or whatever it is? You know, you just kind of go from there in writing the song. But as far as where, I mean, it's literally, I remember one day I was sleeping, and God just woke me up whatever, I mean, it was like about 3 o'clock in the morning, and in 15 minutes, I had about 4 verses to a song in about 15
wow.
minutes. It was just amazing, you know, and that's not something that just always happens, you know, granted. I mean, that's like one of those few and far between things, but it makes a difference. I mean, I can be sitting in my car, and I really believe that I've probably forgotten a lot of songs that I wanted to write down because I was in the car and the thought just came and the melody and the song just came, and it's like, well, I'm in the car, I can't write anything down, and you know, so it makes no difference of where you are. Sometimes God can just speak to you. Sometimes that song is just for you. Sometimes that message is just for you. But when He allows you to begin to pin that, you know, and begin to get that and bring it to fruition, you can see that it's been for other people. But wherever God speaks to you, I mean, you just don't know. I can be in the middle of church service, and God can give me a song, you know, and a lot of times I begin to now have a little pen and paper and a little notepad or on my iPad or phone or whatever, and just start taking notes. And whenever that comes to me, I begin to now just take notes because I know that, you know, God, if you're speaking and this is something that, you know, I know that you're giving me, you know, I want to make sure that I hold on to that. So, you know, for me, it's no particular place, you know, outside of being in that place of Christ. You know, that place of being tuned in to Him, that's the place for me that you have to be to get the song, and then you just basically go from there.
Amen.
I'm gonna have to piggyback off my brother there for a minute. And I definitely agree with everything he said. Because growing up, when I got into music, you know, God would wake me up. I would wake up at an early age, and I never knew why that was happening to me. But I would wake up in the middle of the night. My mother would come in my room. She'd be like, what are you doing up? And she would see me writing music, but she wouldn't stop me. She would let me keep doing it. You know, and over time, you know, I started to understand, you know, when I got saved, that God was giving me all these songs that He wanted me to write. You know what I'm saying? He was training me. See, when I was in the secular world, I was a hip-hop artist, but I was using it in a different way. But God was training me for times such as this. You're going to learn how to use your words. You're going to use all the training that I gave you as you was growing up. But this is why. You know, God don't treat me like He treat a regular hip-hop artist. Like they can ride around, see what they see. Oh, I'm going to write about that. Oh, I'm going to write about that. No, you know, God, like when God gets to Corinth to a point to do a song, God guts me for it. You know what I mean? You know, I got a song on my album that I just did tonight called Last Man Standing. It's about, you know, war with a Jezebel spirit. You know what I mean? And most people don't understand. Most people don't understand what that is until you go through it. But the war with a Jezebel spirit can be something very painful. You know what I'm saying? So for me to understand the calling on my life and understand, you know, the responsibility I have in words and even the responsibility that I have with working with ourselves, I have a responsibility. You know what I mean? Everything I say, how I say it, the way I say it, who I say it in front of, you know, even what I put down on wax. So the song Last Man Standing is definitely about the fact of, you know, at the end of the day, my mom always told me, you can give up or don't give in. And when she told me that and I got saved and I understand scripture more to the aspects of my life and what God wants me to write about, you know, I can go to Jesus and I was like, God, what you want me to write about this time? And I learned this time that when you ask God for something, you better mind out how you ask Him, when you ask Him, and where you ask Him, because you get exactly what you ask for. And when I asked Him to show me what He wanted me to write about for this new album, God sat me down for what, like 4 years. But I went through something for those 4 years to get to this album. And this is one of the best albums I ever done. So, you know, I agree with Howard. I can be in my car. God will tell me something. Or I can listen to a song. And I'll repeat something over and over and over and over again. You know, and one of the other different things about the Corinth is that I could watch a movie. I could watch a whole movie. And when I watch that whole movie, it may be one piece of that movie that I will remember. You know what I mean? And I'm not like your regular hip hop artist. If I'm going through something, I don't sit down, I'm gonna make the song sound like this. I gotta piece it together before I actually write it. I don't have a home studio. So what I think about where I'm at, my car, is my studio. You know what I mean? One of the songs on my album is called When You Wake Up. You know, and I got that, you know, just to give an idea, that song is from a personal experience from the point of a woman
saying to you, like, hey, I need to know that I can depend on you. I need to know that you're going to be the leader in this household. I need to know that you're going to lead me according to the word of God. I need to know that every time I wake up or when I don't got it, you got it. You know what I'm saying? And when you wake up, I got that from watching a movie with Matthew McConaughey in it. He told a young lady, he said, give me one more chance. When you wake up and you open your eyes, I'll be there. I promise. And all he said was, when you wake up, I'll be there. And that's the only part of that movie that stuck with me. But it helped me to understand that when you're doing ministry, you're writing a song, even with my brother, they're like, okay, I just told Howard this. And I don't want to ramble. I'm going to get to my point and I'll be done. I just told Howard this in PA. We was in PA, and Howard does this song called I Love You, Lord. And I tell him, like, bro, every time you do that song, I get a different meaning from that song. But every time you do that song, you put these people on their feet. I love you, Lord. You know, I love you, Lord is one of my best songs off Howard's album. Not that he don't do it, but it's the fact that he's saying something that I say every day, that I say when he says it. I have to say it with him. I love you, Lord. You know what I'm saying? I worship you, Lord. You know what I'm saying? You know, and it's like every time he do that song, I'm letting him know now, bro. You got a hit on your hands because it definitely speaks to me every time you do it. And it's like I agree with him with the way God uses us to put music together.
Mm. Wow. All right, Pastor Bello.
Hey. Okay.
You got some
so
stuff on here.
So, the question, I want to where did the Corinthians come from? Nobody asked that question.
I was born in East St. Louis, Illinois, you know, and that's my home city. I love my city.
I'm in St. Louis. Hey, it's your birthday.
Yep. I'm from there, you know, and okay. I've been in Minnesota for about a good 25, 30 years, you know, but East St. Louis is where I'm from. That's where I'm from.
I know that's not your good government name. So how did you come up with that name?
The Corinth?
Yes.
The way I got that name, you know, okay, I'm gonna make a long story short, real short. That name was birth because when I hit rock bottom, I had a personal conversation with Jesus, and this was before CMG was born. And I sat in my car, and I was homeless, and I had, I lost everything. You know, a pastor friend of mine is out of Alabama. He had got my first album. He told me, he said, man of God, you need to get ready for the ride. At that time when I heard that, I had just put out The Storm Is Over. You know, he told me, he said, you wrote your testimony, but you need to get ready for the ride. I'm thinking I'm about to blow up. A pastor has spoken to my life. I'm like, man, it's about to be on. Like that. So when I hit rock bottom was when I lost everything. Everything. I sat in my car and I told God, I said, Lord, you bring me back to the gospel. I promise I will do it your way, not my way. And I won't compromise my belief. I won't compromise nothing for the sake of anyone. I will do exactly what you have instructed me to do. I need to redefine myself. Show me who you want me to be. I went, and it's like, my favorite verse in the Bible is 1 Corinthians chapter 13. That's my favorite verse in the Bible because I believe in the structure of love. I believe in how God ordains a man to love a woman. I believe in that. But I believe in how God wants us to love his people, no matter no right or no wrong. I believe in that. So the Corinth is, you know, given to me because I have a big heart for people. I help anyone. It doesn't matter to me because I know God is going to bless me and I know he's going to use me. So it doesn't matter if a person hurt me tomorrow, I know God gonna bless me the next day. So I'm not worried about it, you know. And the Corinth, and when I started out as the Corinth 13. I dropped 13 because my birthday is July 13th, so I put the two together, you know. And then when I look at the Corinth, that's who I am. Every time a person see the Corinth's name, no matter where I'm going, I'm bringing love to the stage. I don't care if it's a hardcore song or whatever. You best believe I'm bringing love to the table. You're going to hear songs for the love for women. You're going to hear everything when you see the Corinth on the table. And one thing that I try not to go into preaching when I get on stage, but it just happens. So, you know, that's how I got the name.
Amen. Now, before I ask y'all to let us know how people can get in touch with you, especially, you know, if they want to book you for future reference, I'm going to ask Howard because I know that we will be privileged because Mrs. Sapp is joining us.
Yes. Yes.
So I want to know how does she relate to all this? You know, how does she feel about you traveling here, traveling all those things?
She realizes the calling on my life, even before the traveling and everything. She knew who I was in Christ, and I know to
you ready
for both of us.
You ready?
And she has a calling on her life also. You know, so she understands, and that's the biggest thing. You know, have a good understanding first and foremost of Christ and how God is working in our lives and how God is actually moving and, you know, the different seasons that he has, you know, have us in, you know, season of preparation, you know, a season of learning and a season of growing and then a season of doing. And, so she definitely understands that, you know, but I also have to understand that, you know, even with all of that, you know, I still have a responsibility, you know, for my family. So, you know, I make sure that, you know, they're taken care of. You know, when I have the downtime, I spend that time, you know, with them and making sure that they have everything that they need and, you know, a husband, a father, you know, provider, whatever. So she's certainly there with me. And of course, you know, we have a daughter, so we have to make sure that, you know, we take care of her and she, you know, gets the things that she needs, you know. So when we're able, she definitely travels with me. You know, sometimes she can, sometimes she can't, but, you know, I've always told her, you know, whenever you can, I want you to, you know, to be with me, because I do believe in people of seeing a strong, you know, a strong family, you know, moving forward in Christ together, you know, because that's, you know, within everything, you know, you go out there and you're traveling, you're on the road and you face troubles. You face, you know, there are battles, like you said before, you know, that the enemy don't stop, you know, regardless, he don't stop. He doesn't care. You know, so, you know, whenever we can, we certainly like to travel together. So, you know, I told her, you know, if you can make it, you know, let's make it happen. And so, you know, I you know, would certainly love her to be there and be in ministry with me. And she's there. She's a big, big supporter. My daughter's a big supporter. So, you know, when even if she can't, you know, she would, you know, certainly, you know, continue to support me. And you know, she's just always there. So it's going to be a joy to have her there with me.
Amen, amen. So let us know how they can get in touch with you. We're going to start with our brother Howard Sapp first, and then we'll go to the Corinth. And I want to say, too, as we end, is that we need to know that every day we should practice Psalms 100, which make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And the reason, I'm going to tell you the truth, the reason I love that part is because I wish I could sing. So everything that comes out of my mouth that's a song, I know it has to be a joyful noise to the Lord, because he has never complained about it. Now, some of the family members have, but the Lord has never complained about it. So, brother, how was that? Let us know how you could sing.
Amen, amen. It's all good, you know, that's the thing about God, you know. I mean, you know, like they said, little is much when you place it in his hands, you know. So, I mean, for me, it doesn't really matter, you know, God, whatever I have, you know, because I would be one of the first to say, like, you know, I'm not perfect, you know. I may not, hit the mark all the time, but God, I'm giving you 100%. You know, I'm swinging for the fences, you know. So, you know, when I get up to bat, you know, I'm swinging for the fences. I'm going for the home run. So, regardless of how it sounds, God, I'm giving everything I got. You know, I'm giving everything I got. But certainly, I'm going through, you know, to get in contact with us, you know, definitely, you know, the Quint and myself, you know, through Centerstone Media Group. You can, you know, certainly centerstonemediagroup.com. You can, you know, hit us on the website, and we're having a new web page that's coming up that should be out here very, very soon. So you'll be able to, you know, certainly link up with us and, you know, go on and begin to, you know, contact each and every artist, you know, on CMG. You can, you know, contact, you know, myself, you know, personally through, you know, howard.sapp
you know, at AOL.com and you know, but definitely through CMG, through the ministry, CMG, Centerstone Media Group, you know, you can contact us and we'll certainly reach out to you and we'll be available, you know, whenever, you know, anyone wants us to, you know, come to minister and to, or to just a fellowship and just to have a good time. We are always, always there.
Amen. Amen. Okay. Chris, you got something to add?
I would say I agree with Howard. You know, I don't have a spouse to travel with, you know what I mean? So I'm definitely, you know, I'm going to be giving everything I got to the stable, you know what I'm saying? But I'm definitely operating in decency and order, you know what I mean? Until you know, God definitely, you know what I'm saying, you know, plants a wife in my life. But Justin, there's a special someone, I can put you like that. But most importantly, right now, as Howard said, you know, definitely reach out to us, you know. You can reach out to us personally, one-on-one, or what have you, or through Centerstone Media Group. You know, the site will be up in a few weeks, and we're definitely gearing up for a lot of things, and we'll definitely come out. We'll definitely come out, you know, and we'll definitely bring the Lord with us. We'll bring the Word with us, and we're definitely going to, you know, make sure we show out, show up and let the Lord show out.
Amen, amen. Well, I am so happy you took time for everyone that is viewing and listening and will be listening later, that this show will be aired again on the Gospel Jamaican Network. So they're going to run this as a special on Friday. So prayfully, we can catch it once we all get over there and land. But we're doing this so we can bring awareness. And like I was telling the radio host, is that we're not working with a lot of time once we get there. So it's not going to be where we can do an actual formal meet and greet before the concert. We will have a mini red carpet, but it's not going to be one that's going to last enough time for where people can actually ask questions. So that's why we're running this again on Friday out in Jamaica. And again, like I said, I am so grateful that you came on. I am so delighted that you're joining us in Jamaica. And I'm telling you that the Lord will show up in your lives. When you get there, you will understand why you're there. And that's how it was for Pastor and I the first time we were there. We knew that God had led our footsteps to that particular location. And as everyone knows that's on the team that's out there in Jamaica, that this right here is going to be probably the first and last time that we'll actually have it on an inside structure because we're going to have too many people. So the next time it's going to be just abundance, like they say in the Bible, abundance. When you say abundance, that winds it all up right there when you say abundance.
Yes.
So, yes, I thank you. Like for myself, I'm Pastor Rhonda Bello, and I can be reached at the Blessed Network. Please make sure you follow us and friend them so you can follow them because you never know. They might be around the corner at a church that you go to. They might be at a location you get ready to visit or vacation. So make sure you friend them because you want to make sure that we, like I said in the beginning, we lift each other up. We have a hard time doing that. But we always want to be there when the person is already making $55 million. You don't understand that we be thankful for the little because God will give us more. So I encourage everyone to share with your friends. Let them know that we have some gospel artists and they are doing it. They being obedient to God. They stepping out by faith and they are doing nothing less than singing and preaching the word of God. I'm going to turn it over to Sister Kimmy so she can end it, tell us about how they can reach her, and then she can end us in prayer.
Wow, the Corinth and Brother Sapp, I just want to thank you both for coming on. Wow, powerful men in the Lord. I wish I was going to Jamaica. I'm jealous. But this is for you and Pastor Bello. Thank you so much for hearing. Wow, awesome. Well, my name is Kimmy Kim, and you can find me on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and I just want to thank you for this wonderful fellowshipping time on a Wednesday night with these wonderful men. I love hip hop, so you gotta let me know where I can find. You know, I like all type of music. I'm like Pastor Bello. I love singing for the Lord. But let's go to the Father prayer. And before we go, I would like to give a shout out to Jerry Royce on Positive Power 21. Jerry, thank you for this wonderful opportunity, and you will forever be in my heart and my prayers. Thank you so much for this opportunity. And please follow Elation Magazine and Elation Radio on Facebook, and we have wonderful articles. You can also see those articles online at elationmagazine.com. And let's go to the Father in prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, thank you once again for your grace. Thank you for your mercy, Father God. Thank you for just being a wonderful God. Thank you for this fellowshipping time. Let this podcast be about you, not about us. Please, God, bless the Corinth and Brother Sapp and Pastor Bello with safe travel and great time in you, and let them, you know, just spread the good news gospel through singing, because there's nothing like singing. Many people come to you so many different ways, and I just thank you so much for the gifts that you have given us so that we can use them to glorify your name in spirit and in truth. So let's we're going to continue praising you, Father, honor you, and we make this prayer in your Son Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Woo. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Bello. Amen. Thank you, the Corinth. And I just want to thank you so much for your time. And if you guys don't mind, I would love to play some of your music on Elation Radio. If you have the opportunity, is you can email that to me at elationradio@gmail.com. And we're going to sign off. And what a good time. Pastor Bello, did you have anything you want to add?
No, just everyone, make sure you share. And we will see you this weekend in Jamaica.
Jamaica. Amen. I'm so jealous. Oh, that's going to be fun. But have fun for me. I'll be back. I'll be there next year. I'm going to try my best to get there. But I love you all, and be blessed, everyone.
You too. God bless.
Therefore, if anyone is in Messiah, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. The old man dead, he's passed on. Let's have a moment of silence to sing a sad song. Hope it don't last long, cause I gotta run. Got a meeting with the Father, Spirit, and the Son. Got work to be done, working for the kingdom. Man, I used to be dumb till I met Jesus. Now I saw demons kicking out their teeth. Preaching freedom to people on the street with a Tim to me. Rhymes unique, put it together like a duck and hot cake is sweet. So, taste to see that the Lord is good. Happy is the man who trusts him like he should. If you're up to no good, get saved. Without Jesus, man, it's just flame. And the Lord will change you from the inside. And the next thing you know, that old man has died. In my chest and it pierced my flesh, sank to my heart. Now I'm a brand new man, I got a new start. I'm pushing for the mark, I'm set, ready to go. I'm running full speed and I'm about to blow like a time bomb, but I can't stay calm, cause I got a fire burning in me like napalm. Used to be way gone, hooked on drugs. Now I just pray long, I'm hooked on love. It come from up above, you can have it too. Believe and receive, that's all you gotta do. The Lord standing at the door, don't you hear him knock? Waiting for you patiently to open up the lock. When you finally do, and he walks inside, with just a little talk, that old man has died. See the old man now has died, and inside the Lord I hide. Underneath his mighty wing, hallelujah, joy he brings. I got peace within my soul. Overwhelmed, I lose control. I just got to give and pray, cause I know my death and the old man's dead, it's 6 feet deep, and I'm covered in blood from the top of my head to the only blood to make your life complete. It's good for the hood, good for the healing. free and heal. And the blood that was spilled to heal your heart was the precious blood of the Son of God.
On the cross for you we died.
Run that back.